our very own first lady, giving us words of encouragement.
About Mother's Day this morning, I don't have the most beautiful yarn in the world, but I love my flowers.
Yeah.
And I love my front and I love my back, so I went back. Had a little difficulty at first, but I decided to go back to the back and think about when I was raised and who raised me. And I thought about my great grandmother, Clara Solomon, and my grandmother, Earlene, and my beautiful mom.
Yes.
Mother Rose and myself, and then here comes Monique. And I wanted to speak about, and I thought about how they raised us, and that's how I love my flowers, because of them. And a flower means something because it's a special gift from God. Amen.
Amen.
God bless Jason. Yes. In the name of Jesus. Amen. And today I want to talk about the covenant of a motherhood. And remember, you have 9 months to carry, 3 years to carry on your hip, and a lifetime. The covenant of a mother. This is when Hannah wanted to have a baby for Eli. And it's, she made a covenant with the Lord. Amen. 1 Samuel 1:11 says, then she made a vow and said, O Lord of hosts, if you will indeed look on the affliction of your maidservant and remember me and not forget your maidservant, but will give your maidservant a male child, then I will give him to the Lord all the days of my life, and no razor shall come upon his head. Amen. Covenant she made. I'll bear with you.
That's good.
It is easy to give your children back to the Lord if you understand from the beginning that they aren't yours to have anymore. Remember that. Hannah was committed to the covenant of motherhood before she even had a child. But it's not important to gather your faith and turn your children over to God in later years. You are his chosen steward for the children he has given you. The greatest tragedy is that many mothers end up with resentful children who feel smothered and angry because they are made to feel guilty for growing up. Preserve what you have with your children by allowing the relationships to change. In your own hands, the caterpillar has been fed in the cocoon of your teaching. It has forth a butterfly. It will never crawl again. It will never need what it once needed. But in every floater, it is lovely wings. There is a tribute to the to the cocoon that permits the grace of change. Your authority will never change. You will move from the role of diaper changing, decision making, and discipline enforcing. Cheerleader and champion. That is not promoting disrespect, but development. If you respect yesterday's child and realize that he has become today's adult, he will always love you for your tremendous contribution to that independence. One of the greatest challenges is this adjustment, is defining boundaries. During this time, children must learn to practice independence with being disrespectful. Young people will blunder, and what that means is stupid or make careless mistakes. Through the transition from Barbie doll to beauty shop, from the golf cart to the golf course.
My Lord.
But did most us stumble into destiny? Children cannot exist their extension or their parents. We all have a story if we admit it. Look at Luke 2 and 51 through 52. Jesus returned home with his mother and continued to submit to her. Where did Jesus go? At the age of 12, they went on a journey, and as they wait on their way back, Jesus went with them. They realized. And so what they do, they turn around and went back to get Jesus. They asked him, what was you at? He said, I was by my Father's business. So we shall bring up our children to learn the word of God. Amen. And thank you to the youth directors. But the scripture says that from that time, he increased his wisdom and stature. In his favor with God and men, he did not disassociate from his mother, who's loyal to follow him all the way to the cross. Although their role changed and he became increasingly independent, he had love and care for his mother, continued even his 33rd year and the founding moment of his life, she will still be his mother. 9 months in the stomach, 3 years on the side, and a lifetime of love in their heart. So mothers, you are a great mother. And you can be a better mother. You can be whatever people think you should be. But knowing from your heart, God gave you that child. And he gave you the ability to raise them. And if you don't know the word, just come and learn the word. Read the word. And there's a lot of great mothers in the Bible to follow. Children, don't disrespect your parents. If they tell you something, just call them. I know I'm only up here for encouragement. I have to give to Sister Pal. She was outside a couple of weeks ago, and she was with her children. And they was doing something, I don't know. All I seen was she peached each one of them. They didn't mumble. They didn't give a sad face. They didn't another that. So Sister Cal, whatever you're doing, I told your husband, keep doing it. You're doing a great job. We love you. Happy Mother's Day.
Thank you. Oh,
Lord. Heal, set free, and deliver. Like, oh,
yeah, Lord. God, we just know that if you would just come in, everything would be all right. In the powerful name of Jesus, we ask her. Let everyone look it up and say amen.
Amen. So Hannah rose up after they had eaten in Shiloh, and after they had drunk. Now Eli the priest sat upon the seat of the post of the temple of the Lord. Let's go on a little bit. And she was bitterness of soul and prayed unto the Lord and wept bitterly. And she vowed about, here we go, and she vowed a vow and said, O Lord of hosts, if thou wilt indeed look on the affliction of thine handmaid.
Yes, Lord.
And remember me and not forget thine handmaid.
Yeah.
but with the give unto thine handmaid a male child.
Male child.
I just want to start right there. Give me.
Give
me. Just a male child.
Amen.
Yeah. I want to talk about just for a few minutes, and it's going to be for a few minutes. A mother's love.
Talk about it.
A mother's love. Now, let me get this out the way before we get into the sermon.
All right.
Men, we need to appreciate what we got.
Amen.
Men, we need to, there you go, Taylor. We need to appreciate, men, what we got.
Amen.
A woman has the ability
Talk about it.
Reproduce
multiply
whatever we give her.
Yeah.
We give them a sperm, they give us a baby.
Mano, talk about it.
We give them groceries, they give us a meal.
Mano.
We give them a house, they give us a home.
Yeah.
We give them trouble, they give us hell. Amen. A mother's love. Back in 1970, before a lot of you was born, we was at the Mount Hermon Baptist Church on Rosedale under the leadership of Dr. S.T. Alexander.
All right.
And as a youngster, Kwanzaa, we didn't have any choice. We had to worship, we had to sing in the choir with whatever Mama told us to do. That's what we had to do. And I remember in the choir as a young boy, Mac, we was there, you was at Dr. Kirvin, and we used to sing a song that back there that is an old hymn, and we don't sing it anymore, but it was a whole song, and I'm pretty sure our senior citizens remember it, and it goes something like this. I made a vow.
Yeah.
To the Lord.
Yeah.
I made a vow to the Lord. And I promised him that I will go all every step of the way. Amen. Hannah, a mother's love, a mother's sacrifice. Mothers know how to make sacrifices. For they will go to the great length, even to cost their own well-being, to make their children happy.
Well.
In the account that we see this morning, we will witness a mother's love for God and her son. Her love for God was so great that she would sacrifice something very dear to her. And her love for her son was so immersed that she released her hold on life so that he could go on to have the Lord's best. This is the account of a mother's sacrifice. As we look at her sacrifice, I'm hoping we can gain some insight and some encouragement that can help us apply to these Christian mothers today as they make sacrifice for both God and family. Mothers. This message is also a tribute to the many who have sacrificed and the sacrifice you have made. And I hope you will believe that you did not make them in vain.
Well.
Yes. Your children and your God appreciate all that you have done.
Well.
And your children are better individuals because of your love. And also the Lord's kingdom has been advancing because of your dedication to the church. And you have greatly gained. May you freely receive and be blessed by God. Had a dream to have a son. The Bible said, now there was a certain man in Remanathan. I may not be pronouncing
these names right, amen. But y'all just read love with me. I'm in the Bible, verse 1. In the mountain of Ephraim, and his name was Echonai, the son of Joram, the son of Elihu, and the son of Tohu, the son of Zippu. Amen. Amen. The Ephraimite. Amen. Amen. And he had two wives. The name of one was Hannah, and the name of the other was Peniah. Peniah had children, but Hannah had no children. Here we are to introduce to the star of this message.
Yes. All right.
The star is Hannah. And we read that Hannah had no children. Hannah was barren up to this point in her life. In the day and time, it's an emotional strain of situation to be an infertile woman. A woman felt obligated to provide her husband with children, especially a son. For father desired a son to help him, amen, with the work, to carry on the family business, too, especially to keep the family name going. Children provided a woman with a sense of self-worth and were part of her identity. The bottom line is that children were very important, and they are still important today. But what we see in this scripture, Hannah dreamed of having a son for her husband. Hannah was barren. But her name provide to us some insight, amen, for her coming future. The name Hannah means grace. Amen. And the word grace means a free gift. And Hannah was about to receive and give away a very special gift. She received, or going to receive, but after a while she's going to give back the gift that she had. Hannah made a vow to the Lord. The Bible said, then Echonai, her husband said to her, Hannah, why are you weeping? Why are you not eating? And why are your heart so grieved? Am I not better than 10 sons? So Hannah rose after they had finished eating and drinking in Shiloh. And now Eli the priest was sitting by the seat of the doorpost of the tabernacle of the Lord. And she was in bitterness of soul and prayed to the Lord, and she wept. She just wasn't letting the truth drop on her. She was really crying. Then she made a vow and said, Lord of hosts, if you indeed look on the affliction of your handmaid and remember me, and not forget your handmaid, but you would give your male maidservant a male child, then I will give him to the Lord all the days of his life. And watch it. And she said, and no razor shall be upon his head. Right here, Hannah and her husband were at the yearly Passover feast. And we read that she was weeping in verse 3 to 7. And we learned the reason why she was crying.
Talk about it.
Peniah, amen. Echonai, other wife. Amen. You can I stop you? Can I put it right here? You know how, amen, when some of you young ladies who amen.
Right.
You know how you got a boyfriend, but you know the boyfriend got another woman on the side. Now this really, come on, help me. Now, why in the world?
Why
would you go on and fight her?
And
not fight him.
Come on.
Why do you? Why do you? Now, and him together, but him went and got somebody else. So why you want to fight her and not fight him? It gets me to see these young ladies fighting in the street, oh, and he's sitting back.
Yeah.
Hannah was there.
Yeah.
Peniel had one, had children.
Yeah.
And I can just imagine.
I got a baby. You may not know. I got a baby.
And so after time, it was so important for a woman to have a baby, especially a male child. Yeah. Now she's teasing her, she's messing with her. They go, Place our dreams above God and and analyze them.
Well.
The Lord will honor your heart's desire. You see, Hannah wanted her dream so badly, amen, that she was willing to give that dream up to God. If you would bring it to pass. Revealing that God was first, she declared, if you will, give your handmaid, your maid servant, a male child.
Then
I will give him to the Lord for all the days of his life. So we see that she would choose to give away her dreams once she received what she asked the Lord for. So Hannah made a vow to God, and the Dr. Schofield said Hannah did not bargain with the Lord. Rather, she provided her spirituality. She proved her spirituality by willing and offering God her best. Are you willing to give God her firstborn? What significance about a vow? The New Bible Dictionary reads, a vow is a sacred binding as an oath. Therefore, a vow should not be made hastily for the wrong reason. Then enter into the spirit of the offering. And is released only when the sacrifice is made. Ecclesiastes 4:5-6 says, when you make a vow to the God, do not delay to pay it, for he has no pleasure in fools. Pay what you have vowed. Better not the vow than to vow and not pay. Do not let your mouth cause your flesh to sin, nor say before the messenger of God that it was an error. Why should God be angry at your excuse and destroy the works of your hands? Here, Hannah was obligated to perform what she vowed, which was a Nazarite vow, a vow of consecration of her firstborn to God's service. Hannah's willingness to vow in such a way was to vote confidence that the Lord will be faithful to bring her dreams to pass. Mom, can you want dreams so badly that you're willing to vow a promise to use that dream for God's glory and the service in his kingdom? Believe it or not, it's been done before. I have friends who had a premature baby. And Lord, when you're premature, you come before time. And she promised, Lord, if you just let him leave, I'll get it dedicated to your life. Now watch this. I'm going to put a pin on this 5 inches. And I know it's customary. I know we do it because we, mama done it, and then we done it as grown up. Why bring your baby down to be dedicated, and you ain't dedicated yourself? Why go through the formality of coming and saying, I'm giving you back to God, and you ain't righteous, and you hardly ever come to church? What foolishness it is for you to make, a mockery out of God, because you know you ain't coming to church right, you ain't serving God right, but you said, I'm going to dedicate him back to God. And you ain't doing no work yourself.
My Lord.
Why?
If you're willing to sacrifice or surrender your dreams to God, then he will honor that and make your dreams come to pass. When you make a promise, a vow to surrender something to God, then you must be willing to let it go when the time comes. Verse 20 said, it came to pass in the process of time. Hannah conceived and bore a son and called his name
Samuel,
saying, because I have asked for him from the Lord. Then a man, Ananias, and all his house went up to offer to the Lord a yearly sacrifice and of his life. But Hannah did not go up, for she said to her husband, not until the child is weaned. Then I will take him, that he may appear before the Lord and remain there forever. So Ananias, her husband, said, unto her, do what seems best for you. Wait until the child is weaned. Only let the Lord establish his word. Then the woman stayed and nursed the son until she had weaned him. Verse 24 said, now when she had weaned him, she took him up with her with three bulls, one ephah of flour, and a skin of wine, and brought him to the house of the Lord of Shiloh. And the child was young. Then she slaughtered the bull, brought the child to Eli. Verse 20 said, that the Lord gave her a heart's desire. And she conceived and gave birth to a son. She named that son Samuel, which means asked of God, or heard of God. Revealing that God heard us and is faithful whenever we surrender to him. How many of you here today can say that God is faithful? How many of you have ever had a dream to come true and you say God is faithful? He's faithful to his word. Can you let it go though? Have you ever had a dream for your children? For many mothers, their children become their life. And so they pour everything, their time, their energy, their hearts into their children. Sometimes they even attempt to relive their life through their children. Mothers are so willing to let your children go if the Lord asks you. So Hannah did. It would be a lot easier. Amen. To sacrifice your dream. Or to give your children to God's service. It is the Lord. He's the Lord of your life. If your joy in life is based totally on your kids or your dream, then it would be difficult to let it go. If your joy and hope is founded on the Lord, then you will more easily release your hold to God. Psalms 37 and 4 said, I delight yourself so in the Lord, and he shall give you the desires of your heart. We must make sure that the Lord is first in our lives. Can I get a witness here? And that we delight in him. When we do, he will give our hearts desire. But more importantly, he will be our greatest desire. We read here that we are following a year Passover roll around. And Hannah did not go up and offer sacrifice. And she did immediately pay her vows. She took time to wean Samuel before she gave him over to the Lord for service. And we do not find anywhere where the Lord was displeased with Hannah's decision. I come to tell you, Dr. Stuart Schofield said, Jewish women weaned their children about to the age of three. And at that time, Hannah took Samuel to Eli. Amen. And fulfilled her vows to the Lord. Hannah was given her dream, her son, and she was allowed to enjoy that dream just for a little while. God is not some lofty kind joy looking to take away the things that give you pleasure. Amen. But the Lord loves us. And he will often provide us with a weaning period for our dreams. A time of where we are nature and mature and care for and enjoy the gift that God has granted us. If we allow to take the joy in that gift that God has entrusted to us, we will be better steward of that gift. So that when the time comes to turn it over to the Lord, or give the Lord our best offering, our first fruit to God, if the Lord allow us the opportunity to joy I drink. Whatever it may be, you would turn it over to the Lord. Amen. The first fruit offering. Can I get a witness here? You will give the Lord your best. Can I get a witness here? Is anybody here ready to give God your best? Hannah gave the Lord her best. After Samuel was weak, Hannah sacrificed him as an offering to the Lord to be used in God's service. And because God was first in her life, it was an act of worship. She not only presented what she vowed, but she gave above and beyond what she vowed. She gave an offering to the Lord and other gifts. Three moves, some flour, and a thing of wine. And of course, these are prescribed items that should accomplish a vow described in the book of Numbers, chapter 15, yes, 8 to 10. But what I want to point out is that Hannah gave, and she gave, and she gave. Which is typical for many moms. They just keep on giving. Oh, see, some of you moms all over this shot right there. Because you give. You keep on giving. And you give some more. Am I right about it? One thing that is unmistakable is how a mother would give to a child and her family. We can see a mother giving an example of a victorious woman in Proverbs 31.
All right.
You know the story of a virtuous woman. How she get up early. She stay late. She makes sure her family is taken care of. She don't run off like a lot of y'all do and hope somebody else take care of your business. A mother would sacrifice her own needs and wants for her children so they can have what they want. For example, a mother might wear, the same old clothes for many years so that children can have some new clothes. A mother might wear the same old gown. You know, my mamas wear those gowns. I ain't talking about these new women. I'm talking about old mamas. Wear that old gown. They have to wear it every day. They wear it. They wash it. They keep on wearing. They keep on washing it. So their children can have some brand new. Amen. A mother would make sure children eat before she tonight. A mother makes sure her children's clothes are clean. Amen. Before her. To give, and from the way women give to the church of their time and energy to keep the church ministry going. It's no doubt that a woman knows how to give to God as well. Let me make sure we honor our mothers for their giving, their motherhood, and always remember to keep giving to the Lord. And as we get ready to close this morning, we need to honor our mothers. Thank you for your sacrifice. Have simply worship the Lord. Verse 26 said, and my Lord, and your soul live. My Lord, I am a woman who stood by you here praying to the Lord. I'm still in the Bible. Verse 27, for this child I prayed, and the Lord would grant me my petition which I asked of him. Therefore I would have lent him to the Lord. As long as he lives, he shall be lent to the Lord. So they worshiped the Lord there. So soon as Hannah gave her son Samuel to Eli, the priest would read, so they worshiped the Lord there. Verse 28. And once again, Hannah demonstrated that her joy, her hope was founded in the Lord. For she rose above her heartaches, and that she may have experience to worship and focus on God. Mothers, I'm sure that you experience many heartaches and pains. Perhaps your husband walked out on you and left you as a single mom to raise the kids all by yourself. Maybe you're a stay-at-home mom and you and your husband are trying to live off one income to fight with new financial difficulties. Maybe your teenager living rebelliously and packed perhaps a child getting in all sorts of trouble. And you got one ready to leave the nest. But when trouble surrounds you, the best thing you can do is worship the Lord. I read in Philippians chapter 4:89. It says, whatever things are true, whatever things are noble, whatever things are just, whatever things are pure, whatever things are lonely, whatever things are good report, if there be any virtue, if there be anything praiseworthy, meditate on these things, and the God of peace will be with you. I'm focusing on God and on his blessings. I'm focused on the good things. You will distract from the throne. However, we do not worship God just for distraction. We worship him because he's worthy. When you sacrifice your dreams to God, also be sure to bring him a sacrifice. Am I right about it? We got to give him a sacrifice, but get ready to praise him. Her name means grace.
Yeah.
Grace means
yes.
A free gift.
Yeah.
Hannah was given a gift of a son.
Yes, yeah, sir.
And when he was formally married, but she was willing to give her son back to God as a gift. Out of her love, devotion to the Lord, Hannah got what she wanted. But she got what she wanted and gave it back to God. Give me a gift. And see if I give it back to you. Sister Hyde, give me a gift. And see if I give it back to you.
Yeah.
All right.
God gave us a gift. He gave us a gift. Not worrying about it if you're gonna give it back. Because it's already discovered and already planned. I'ma give it. And I'm going to give it back. Y'all show this part. God gave us a gift over 2,000 years ago. I wish I had a witness here. They talked about it early in the Old Testament. I heard Isaiah talk about it. I heard other prophets talk about it. When the time has come, when the time was at hand, the angel of the Lord came to Mary and said, Mary, you have found favor in the Lord. I wish I had one or two witnesses here. The angel said, thou will be pregnant. And I read in the word, Mary said, how can it be? I don't know no man, but that which is done is going to be of the Holy Ghost. Am I right about it? But that lame angel had to go to Joseph and say, Joseph, don't worry about it. Put Mary aside. That which is done is of the Holy Ghost. I heard and I read the Bible says when it was down in the stable, up came a bouncing baby boy. Am I right about it? His name is Jesus. He knew his stature. Am I right about it? In the age of 12, himself in the house of the Lord. Am I right about it? The Bible says, at the age of 30, he began his ministry, healing the sick and raising the dead, giving sight to the blind, unstopping their fears. I read and I heard. He marched up along out the hill.
Taste and see that the Lord is good.
robbery, that makes me happy. Yeah. At this time, church, the doors of the church are open.
Thank you.